Are you wasting time and would you like to stop? In this video, I'm going to share with you how you can make time elastic and also how you can set your priorities that are going to enable you to spend time the way that you want. So firstly, it is great that you are aware that you are wasting time, because we can often get into this place where we just don't realise, or we're kind of in denial. So when we're in this place, time is slipping by and we actually don't realise that we're wasting it. So even though you might feel a little bit challenged about the fact that you're wasting time, let me tell you, my friend, it is a far better place to be than not being aware that you're wasting time. So tick there, because you're watching this video. And secondly, you want to do something about it. Again, amazing, because so many people are in this position where they're like, I'm wasting time, but I just don't think that there's anything that I can do about it. And so nothing changes. It's really, really amazing that you're now here to try to figure out how to stop wasting time. Great job. Okay. So usually when people become aware that they're wasting time, it's because there's something that they want to happen in their life and they're not able to make it happen, or they're not able to find the time to do the things that they want to do. So for example, I work with writers, I work with creative entrepreneurs, and so time wasting may come up for them because they're trying to make progress with a book, or they're trying to build their business or create more clients, but they're finding that they're not making the most of their time, and they're aware that they're kind of wasting time. They're spending time on things that aren't taking them forward. So I think it can really, really help to start in this place, because if we're in this sort of vague, oh, I'm just wasting time, but we don't know in what way and why that has a negative impact on us, it makes it much more challenging to start to solve the problem. So start to get really clear. How do you know you're wasting time? So how are you judging it? Is it because there's something that you want to do that you're not getting done? Or is it that you're seeing yourself spending your time on things that you don't really think that you should be spending your time on? And here's where we start to then be able to ease ourselves in to really understanding what our priorities are. Because if we don't know what our priorities are, then we're simply going to spend time on the first thing that comes to mind, or we're just going to spend time automatically, as in the way we've always continued to spend it. But if we want to be creating new businesses or new lives, we have to learn how to spend time in a different way. So let me talk to you a little bit about this idea of time being elastic, and then I'm going to really help you start to get clear about how you can create really vital priorities in your life that are going to enable you to start spending that time the way that you want. So in terms of this concept of time being elastic, have you ever been in a place at work, or if you're freelance, you've been working for yourself and you have felt like you simply just didn't have the time? There was so much on your plate and you were really struggling to keep up. I think we can probably all relate to having some version of that. And then have you ever gotten sick? So you might have suddenly come down with something and then just been completely out of action, maybe for a day, maybe for 2 days, maybe even for a week. Now, again, we can probably all relate to that, having gotten sick and not been able to work. And what we discover is that kind of overwhelm, this like, I've got so much to do and it just feels really scary and urgent and, oh my God, I'm never going to get it done in time. But then when we get sick, it's suddenly okay that none of that stuff got done. So that's what I mean about this idea of time being elastic. If we suddenly have to spend our time in a certain way, as in I've now got to spend 2 days in bed because I'm sick, something happens in terms of what we think needs to get done. And it doesn't all have to happen straight away in exactly the way that we think it has to happen. Or if we get sick, suddenly we've got a lot more time available to us in order to enable ourselves to get better. I've had situations where I've had like a disaster happen at home, like my boiler has leaked all over the floor, and suddenly the whole day that I thought I was going to spend working is suddenly spent with plumbers and builders. but it's somehow been okay. I've suddenly somehow managed to find that time to spend with those plumbers and those builders. So I think it's really important to understand that time will really stretch to what's most important. And so if being sick is the most important thing, your health, time is going to stretch. If the fact that your boiler has started to leak and you need to suddenly be on the phone to plumbers and builders, time is going to stretch. So that's why it's so important to have those priorities, because if you don't have those priorities, time is not going to stretch in the way that you want it to stretch. So let's have a look at these priorities and to really get clear about how we can create them. Because here's the thing, if you're wasting time, what that suggests to me is that you don't yet have those priorities set up in a way that's really beneficial. So it might be that you're trying to work on a writing project, but you're aware that you're wasting time because you're not spending time on your writing. Now, it could be that in your mind, you haven't actually prioritized the writing project. It may be because you think the writing project isn't going to go anywhere, or it's not going to make you any money, or it's probably not going to develop in a way that you want it to develop. And so you haven't given it that importance. You've given friends or family importance. You've given other kinds of work importance, or you've just given spending time online and enjoying yourself importance because you get that sort of quick fix from it. So the way that I would work with a client in terms of helping them prioritize so they can stop wasting time, rather than think about what their priorities are right now, because here's the thing, if you knew what your priorities were right now, you wouldn't be wasting time. So it can be really challenging to be like, what are my priorities right now? Like, I don't really know, to be honest. That's why you're wasting time. So it's to actually look a year into the future. So I want for you to imagine a year from now, I want for you to imagine 3 to 5 things that you would love to have in your life. So it might be that a year from now, you would love to have fitness, like a beautiful fitness goal as a part of your life. So a part of my life might be that I know that I can consistently run 10K. Or a part of my life might be that I'm now eating a plant-based diet because I know that's going to be really good for me. Or it might be that a part of my life is that I'm now running my own business. So a year from now, what 3 to 5 things do you want as a part of your life, a part of your career? And also, I think it can be really important to put relationships in there too, because they're often the thing that gets shoved to the bottom of the pile. So 3 to 5 things, look at your life, look at your career, and look at your relationships. So now you're coming back to the present moment and you're now clear about what you're going to need in order to prioritize to make those things happen a year from now. So that way we're really getting clear about what we're giving importance to today. So if you've made health or fitness a priority in a year's time, you know you're going to have to make it a priority today. Or if you've made running your own business a year from now a priority, you know that that's going to be a priority today in order to make that happen. And then in order to really get into that place where we're spending the time in the way that we want to spend it, excuse me, we then want to begin to break it down. So it's to understand there are 168 hours in a week. So even if you're working full time, so say you're spending 40 of those hours a week working full time, you're sleeping 8 hours a night, there's still 72 hours left that you can now start using in the way that you have begun to prioritize. And so you're starting to use those hours that are going to help you create the way that you want, or live the way that you want, or earn the way that you want. Those are the niches that I will be working on with my clients. I'm helping them prioritize so they can create, live, and earn exactly the way that they want. So that's how to start to break it down so that you then get really clear about the way that you want to spend your time. But make sure you want to look a year into the future. Otherwise, it's going to be really difficult to get clear on those priorities, because if you already knew them, you wouldn't be wasting the time. So I'm curious, let me know in the comments below, what are the things that you want to start prioritizing in your life? What would it mean to start to spend those left hour 72 hours on the things that you want to prioritize? And how do you feel about being able to create and live and earn the way that you want? If that appeals to you, then you might be interested in my free masterclass. You can grab it right now. There's a link below. You'll be able to fill in your details. We'll send you the masterclass straight away and you can start watching it today. It's going to give you loads of key areas that are going to help you create that career that you want, live in the way that you want, earn the way that you want, and also get clear about what might be holding you back from that. Really great to share this one with you today, folks. Look forward to seeing you on the sofa next week. Take care till then.